In 1969, after the announcement of the decision of the British government on the intention to withdraw by the end of 1971, British troops from the areas located east of the Suez Canal, including from the Gulf states, the principalities signed an agreement on the formation of the Federation of Arab Principalities of the Persian Gulf. On October 22nd, 1969, the Supreme Council of the Federation elected Sheikh Zayed bin Sultan Al Nahyan as the first president of the Federation of the Emir of the Principality of Abu Dhabi. Bahrain and Qatar were supposed to join the Federation, but lately they formed independent states. On December 2, 1971, six of the seven Emirates of Treaty Oman announced the creation of a federation called the United Arab Emirates. The seventh Emirate, Ras Al Khaimah, joined in 1972. In 1974, an agreement was concluded with Saudi Arabia to settle the border dispute. Under this agreement, the Emirate of Abu Dhabi ceded part of its territory to Saudi Arabia, as well as providing a corridor through its territory to the transportation of oil and military purposes, and undertook to jointly develop the Al Khafra area. In return, Saudi Arabia abandoned its claims to the oases of Al Buraimi, Liwa, and several other territories in favor of the UAE. In 1978-1979, there was a border conflict with Oman. The granting of independence coincided with a sharp jump in the prices of oil and all oil products caused by the tough energy policy of Saudi Arabia, which made it easier for the new state to take independent steps in the field of economy and foreign policy. Thanks to oil revenues and skillful investment in the development of industry, agricultural, the formation of numerous free economic zones, and the Emirates were able to achieve relative economic prosperity in the shortest possible time. The sphere of tourism, the industry of tourism and finance has received significant development. In 1990-1991, the troops of the United Arab Emirates took part in the liberation of Kuwait. Now the UAE is one of the most politically stable and economically developed states in the world. Investment attractiveness, competent social policy, the constant development of various business areas, a high level of security, and living standards of UAE citizens make this country a noticeable player not only in the oil market but also in such areas as construction, tourism, agriculture, banking, transport, telecommunications, etc. Saudi Arabia did not accept the UAE state for a long time due to territorial disputes over the Al Buraimi, oil oasis, and several islands. Only in 1974, after negotiations in the capital of the UAE, Saudi Arabia recognized the rights of the United Arab Emirates and Oman to the Al Buraimi oasis. It was given the territory of Sabha Bita, several islands, in exchange from UAE to Saudi Arabia, and the right to build a road and an oil pipeline to the Persian Gulf coast. In addition, the rivalry to the political convictions of the rulers of Abu Dhabi and Dubai did not cool down. Sheikh Abu Dhabi and President Zayed bin Sultan Al Nahyan sought to strengthen the federalism of the state, while Sheikh of Dubai and Vice President Sheikh Rashid bin Zayed Al Maktoum leaned towards the independence of each emirate. In addition, members of the Al Maktoum family, the ruling family of Dubai, occupied most of the key posts in the first cabinet of ministers, prime minister, deputy prime minister, minister of defense, economy, finance, industry. thanks to the correct actions of the ruler of the UAE, by the end of the 70s, the political course of Sheikh Zayed aimed at centralizing power and strengthening the federalism of the state yield results. The UAE armed forces were united. The police, security, immigration, and information agencies were transferred to the jurisdiction of the central government.